Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to work with the Blazor scheduler component of Syncfusion. At the end of this video, you will get a clear picture of how easily you can create and configure the Blazor scheduler in a server-side project. And you will also learn how to bind appointment data to it, and the rest of the major scheduler features, you can explore them very soon in my upcoming videos. Now looking at some live scheduling applications, like a doctor's appointment planner, where you can see n number of appointments booked under different time slots. And next, moving on to the room scheduler, you can see here the rooms are listed one below the other, and each room has been booked in a random timeline, say from 9 to 10, 3 to 4, like that. Now look at the another example, which shows the timings of different flight services on specific route. And here you can see the scheduler is displaying three airline services. In all these examples, you can see the scheduler component playing a major role in it. Now let me begin to create my first server-side Blazor project. For that, I should have the .NET Core SDK 3.1 version in my machine. And next, I should have either the Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 installed in my machine. For this video, I'm going to use Visual Studio Code to create a new Blazor project. So let me open the Visual Studio Code now. When I talk about the Blazor project, I can either create a server-side Blazor application or the client-side WebAssembly application. Here I'm going to create a server project. So let me open the integrated terminal and type the command .NET new Blazor server -o, and then I'll provide the application name as my Blazor scheduler and hit the enter button. This will create a new Blazor project template with the necessary startup and project files. Now to start working with the Syncfusion Blazor components, first I need to add the Syncfusion Blazor package into my project. To add that package, let me type in the command .NET add package syncfusion.blazor-v, and I'll mention the latest version as, and hit the enter button. Now the Blazor package is added and restored into my project. Well, before I add the Blazor scheduler component into my project, first I'll open the imports.razor file, and here I need to add the namespace at using syncfusion.blazor.schedule. Then I'll open the startup.cs file, and here I need to add the Blazor service method. For that, first I'll add the namespace syncfusion.blazor, and within this configure services method, I'll add the add syncfusion blazor method to register the syncfusion blazor service, and within this configure method, I'll add syncfusion.licensing.syncfusionlicenseprovider.registerlicense, and here I need to provide the license key. Now moving on to the host.cshtml page within the pages folder, I'll add a reference to the required CSS. Now everything is configured and it is time to add the scheduler component. So I'll navigate to the index component page, and here I'll remove the existing content. I'll add the schedule component using the schedule tag, and I will also set the initial tValue property to object. Here the tValue is nothing but the type attribute. Now let me run the application with the command .NET watch run, and here you can see the plain scheduler displaying the entire 24 hours with no scroller in it. Also, it highlights my current system date in its current view. So let's move on to the scheduler features now. Usually, the scheduler loads initially with the system's current date, and you can see here my system's current date is February 17. So that particular date is being highlighted on the scheduler now. And in case if I want the scheduler to load with some other date in its current view, then I need to set the selected date property with a specific date value. So within the index component, inside the schedule tag, I'll add the property selected date And here I'll provide the direct value using at new datetime of 2021 and 10. Let me reload the page. And now you can see the scheduler view getting loaded with the provided date January 10. In the same way, if you notice, the scheduler displays the week view by default. To change the scheduler to load in different view, I need to set the current view property with some other view name. Say I have set here view.month. And now you can see here the scheduler is loaded with month view at its initial load. Now let me tell you how to set the start and end hours on scheduler. So let me set the property start hour and set its value to 7. It accepts the value in string format. So I have to provide the value in this way. And for the end hour, I'll provide the value as 15. So now my scheduler should display the time range from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. So let me save these changes. And now moving back to the week view, you can see here the scheduler displaying the time starting from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. I can also hide these weekend days, Saturday and Sunday, by setting show weekend property and assigning its value to false and again reloading the page. You can see here the Saturday and Sunday are not shown on the scheduler now. You can also check it on the week view. Now apart from applying these customizations for all the scheduler views, I can also customize them differently on each view using the schedule views property. Say for example, I can hide the Saturday and Sundays only on the month view. I can set different starter and end hours for this week and work week views. So let's see how to do that now. So to customize each view with different options, I need to make use of the schedule views property, which is of type array. So within the schedule component, I'll add the tag schedule views. And within the schedule views property, I'll add the first schedule view with the option. So here I need to provide the view name. So view dot, I'll give the day view. For this day view, I'm going to set the starter and end hour. Now I'll define another schedule view with option set to view dot week. And now I'll set the starter and end hour from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. And then I'll include another schedule view, nothing but the month view, view.month. And for this month view, I'm going to set the property show weekend and set its value as false. So let me remove this show weekend property from the schedule tag. Another important thing to note here is whatever views I provide within this schedule views property, only those views will be rendered on the scheduler. So you can see only the day, week and month views getting rendered on the scheduler. And now you can see only the day, week and month views are displayed on the scheduler. And the weekend days are hidden on the month view. And in the week view, you can still see the weekend days. But you can notice the start and end hour from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. And if you notice the day view, you can see the difference here as it starts from 7 a.m. and ends at 3 p.m. So this is how you can customize each scheduler views. I'll stop here and continue with the most important topic on how to bind appointment data to the scheduler in my next continuation video. So stay tuned and watch the second part of this video to know about the data binding in scheduler. Thank you.